I'm Hayley Palmer. It's great to have your company this evening, especially as we are joined by international singer and songwriter, plus from the original band of Livin Joy. Yes, it's Janice Robinson. And here is what happened when I caught up with her. Janice, it's great to have you here on the show. How are you today?
I'm great. Thank you for having me. I'm so excited. So excited to be here.
Oh, it's a real pleasure. And where are we speaking to you today? Is it somewhere sunny?
Yes, it's sunny and I'm in Naples, Florida in my home. I live in a tropical paradise and I tell people it's about choices, choices, choices. I always wanted to live either in the mountains or near the ocean or in the forest. So I've got the best of both worlds because I can walk through a forest and I am 8 miles from the ocean.
Wow, I'm so incredibly jealous because I'm talking to you from a rainy London today. So I'm dreaming of that, literally. And speaking of dreaming.
Yes, you're a dreamer.
Absolutely. We're going to play out the first song on the show, Dreamer. Now, this, Janice, takes me back. It really does. When I hear this song, it's just such a feel-good song. And I think anyone of my kind of age, it just takes us back to that place of happy times. That must be a real honour for you to have a song like that that makes people feel like that.
It is an honour. I mean, it's a real honour to have created something that touches so many people and it brings them to such a warm, happy place. For me, it's a huge honor and it just brings a sense of accomplishment and it brings a sense of I gave something to humanity, to so many people in the world that till this day they cherish. And that for me, that's a gift and that's the joy. Yeah,
it really is. Well, it's a massive hit still today. We always hear it. We love it here on the show. Number one, baby, here it is. Livin Joy, Dreamer. Now, Janice, I want to rewind to how everything started for you because you have this incredible voice. Where did you get that voice from?
Well, that voice, I always say when you're born with a gift. And the gifts are assigned to us at birth. I mean, it's just that simple. But I think a lot of it came from being raised in the church and being raised to praise and worship God and just that feeling of what happens when you're in a Baptist gospel church. There's a power, there's a passion. And when your voice is connected to your heart and your soul and you go to sing, you are exuding the passion and love in your heart and soul. So if you love deep, then, you know, my voice is strong because I love strong. So I think that's where it came from. It came from my heart and soul and it was given to me at birth.
Yeah, well, it's definitely a gift. Just wonderful. Thank you. And so I want to talk about Livin Joy because how did that opportunity come about?
Oh, you know, the DJ, Gianni Venturi, he was DJing at a club that my Italian boyfriend at the time, Mauro Patrignani. Wow, I haven't said that name in like almost, wow. You see, I'll start blushing. But, well, I had a wonderful Italian boyfriend and he was promoting parties while he was in college. And Gianluca was one of the DJs. And he knew I had been singing in Milan with Joti Vanelli. And he says, oh, can your girlfriend write us a song? You know, we love her voice. Can she write us a song? And so I really did it as a favor to the DJs because they were just trying to make a record. And I remember them asking me, and my roommate from college was visiting me, and she said, don't you gotta write that song for those guys? I said, oh my God, yeah. And I had my little cassette Walkman with the little piano.
Oh, it takes me back.
And I remember her going, we were on the train going to Venice, and she says, hey, Janice, you gotta write that song before we get there. And I was like, oh my God, yeah, what am I write about? She said, girl, what are you gonna write about? I said, I know what I'm gonna write about. I'm gonna write about love. And she just was like, okay. And I said, nope. I'm gonna write about life. And she was like, okay. And that's it. And then I said, no. And then she started laughing. And then I wrote a piece of paper, laughter. And right then and there, I just felt this energy. And I was like, love, life, and laughter.
Wow.
It is all I believe. and my savior is pure now because my lonely heart would bleed. And there's such a personal message behind it, because we go through life, and so we're going to go through ups and downs. We're going to go through lefts and rights. Mm-hmm. But when your heart is pure, when your soul is pure, when your intentions are pure, then you are just a great asset to humanity, because when you bring a light to others and shine it, that is the beautiful connection. That's why I say we should all be dreamers and just be givers of light, you know? That's where it all came from.
Love that, Janice. I'm feeling really inspired here on tonight's show. I love it having you here. I want to talk about Tina Turner. We're going to play out the best. You opened up for Tina many years ago, didn't you, Janice? What was that like?
It was March 2000. I'll never forget. I was signed to Warner Brothers. I had did like a rock pop album. It was my debut album, actually, just as Janice Robinson. And she chose me out of all the new artists in the world. You know, this icon chose me for her farewell tour. This was her farewell tour, American Arena tour, 50 cities. I felt like I was in class. I felt like I was under her tutelage. I felt like I was getting a PhD in performing, in perseverance, in resilience, in discipline and focus. And I think being a woman of a certain age now, all that education that I gained from being on tour with her, I'm able to access it and use it today.
Wow, just incredible.
Well, even the same red lip, honey. Tina always served the fierce red lip. Woo! I even do the red lip.
Amazing. Well, here is Tina Turner, and I'll be speaking up. I'm speaking to the lovely Janice Robinson on the other side of this. Now, Janice, I know that you have been busy remixing Dreamer. I've seen it on your Instagram. This is really exciting, isn't it? Tell us all about it.
It is. It is exciting. You know, I wasn't planning on re-recording Dreamer, but I was introduced to DJ Lodato, and we had a really amazing conversation. He was signed to Spinning. And, you know, after the years of the pandemic, here I was now, 2021, I thought, okay, let me prepare something great for 2022, because we've all had to pivot. But I thought, let me bring this to a new generation. Let me find someone that can put a modern spin on it. He was 10 years old when Dreamer came out. And so after he told me his testimony, I just thought, this is going to be special. And we re-recorded it, and I trusted him. I just, sonically, it was really, because I'm older and my voice is deeper, but it's just a really youthful, very fitting for this generation. And I wanted to bring that same level of joy to a whole new generation that is dealing with a lot of issues. Like there's a lot going on with the young people, and I love them because I teach them. But I wanted to give them something fresh, something new, something that could give them hope.
Wow. Well, it really does. We're going to check out a clip right now. You're going to absolutely love this. Here is the remix of Dreamer. Enjoy, and we'll see you after.
Love, life, and laughter is all I believe. My Savior is pure now, because my lonely heart would bleed. I never learned how to hold love as a strong to love. But now I close my eyes now, and I'm dreaming right where I need my own.
want to talk to you about X Factor 2018. I remember you coming onto that stage. Firstly, love the outfit. And secondly, I mean, the judges were like, wow, weren't they? When you started singing, they were like, okay. They just adored you. The song, I know, brought back a lot of memories, Dreamer, especially for Robbie Williams, didn't it?
Yeah, he got emotional. Wow.
Oh, bless him. But what was that experience like for you on X Factor?
The experience on X Factor was very surreal. It felt very much like, you know that movie Back to the Future with Michael J. Fox, right? Yeah, I was in a different part of time, and I was experiencing things that I really never experienced before. Talent, competition on TV, in a house with cook, chef. They were all college, you know, college graduate kids working for the producers. And it was just, we need Janice in makeup. We need Janice in styling. We need Janice in wardrobe. We need Janice here. We need. And I, you know, the whole experience, I would say to young people, right? I would say there is nothing better than growing organically. There is nothing stronger than doing grassroots. There is nothing better than just going to an open mic somewhere and singing and let that energy take you to the next thing and to the next thing. What I've discovered is that being in these talent competition shows, they give you too much instant notoriety. An instant notoriety, anything that's instant will lose flavor, honey. You ever make instant food? Yeah. Instant, anything instant does not have everlasting flavor. And so I always tell people, like, you don't, because there's a lot that comes with notoriety. And you have to understand that when the lights go out, when you are in your own space, in your own, truly with yourself, there is a dark side, there is a downside. And so I was really concerned. I could handle it because I know how to be Janice off camera, off stage. And I have Janice, the real life, the mom, the teacher, and friends, and I'm at peace with that. There's something in these talent competition shows that takes you away from yourself and puts you in this big magnifying glass. And it's, some of it's just not healthy. But you gotta learn, all exposure is not good exposure. And you gotta really know how to navigate within yourself. That's why there's so much mental health struggles in young people today. Is that they?
Yeah. No, it's true, isn't it?
Yeah. Yes.
I mean, it's that's good for us watching, back. But I can imagine when you're there, it's a whole different ball game, isn't it? Yeah. But fond memories, nevertheless, because everyone loved you on there, didn't they, Janice?
Thank you. I wanted to inspire the young people because I saw them having very kumbaya, staying up, singing together. I was like, this is not the real world. As an artist, you do not have a career until you are on that radio, until people are calling you to perform and you are getting compensated for your performance. Doing it for free is not a career. I'm just saying.
it's not.
You could have a million followers if you're not able to, you know, you could have thousands of followers. But if it's not keeping the roof over your head, why are you doing it?
No, I understand. Well,
so like sometimes, say,
it's a lesson out there, isn't it? But we're going to go into your next song.
There's
freedom.
A lesson. Yes.
Freedom, Janice. Yes.
This we is all a need freedom, honey. Woo-hoo! Freedom from this pandemic. I wrote Freedom at a time where there was some stuff going on in Libya, and I saw a man of color in shackles. And I, you know, the Black Lives Matters was happening and I saw all the injustices happening. And I just wanted to write something that really talks about we the people, we need freedom from these governments, from these ideologies of just hatred. It's, we need freedom from it. And it's like, we the people, black, white, we have to come together and change the narrative and be about the light, the good. And so freedom is that for me.
Yeah, it's an absolute tune, this one. Enjoy this, freedom, and we will see you on the other side.
What in the world? What has happened? Where is the love? Where is the passion? It's like a sea of mean madness in these two seas, y'all. You see, the world is really shattered. So I'm gonna rise and do what matters. This is the time to just be heard. We need freedom.
Janice, I know that you have a new documentary coming soon. It's called Love, Life and Laughter. That's why I'm loving the name.
Yes.
What can we expect from this?
What you can expect is to see what my life was like after Dreamer. A real bird's eye view into the life of, I would say, yeah, you could say one hit wonder in a sense, but while Dreamer went on to be this big successful record, I'm gonna take people on the journey of where I ended up and how I ended up there and how I ended up taking care of my parents and how I ended up giving them a grandchild and then how I rebuilt my career from scratch because I went from the biggest record in the world to 10-year hiatus. But I kept writing. God. So it'll take you on the journey of what happens to someone when they step away from the spotlight. It's really powerful. Yeah, it's really powerful.
Wow.
Yeah, nobody's ever gone on the inside. Because a lot of people don't want to ever say, oh, I'm just a one-hit wonder. A lot of people don't want to let go to the nostalgia of having a hit. They want to keep living that, like, I still got it. And I'm like, no, it's not that you don't got it. It's just that you're not at number one anymore and you're not in the spotlight. And how I think people are going to realize that artists are really real people, that when they are not on stage, they are just these beautiful, amazing people. And they're complicated at times. I love the story of Daniel Day-Lewis. You know, he's a shoemaker when he's not making movies. And I'm a mom and I'm a teacher when I'm not making dance hits. That's it.
And I think that's keeping it completely real, isn't it, Janice? Because obviously the Instagram world, everyone thinks everyone's got a perfect life. But behind that, like you say, well, everyone's just a real person living their day-to-day life.
Yeah.
So I think your documentary sounds, you know, a real good watch because we're going to really get to see behind the scenes.
People are going to connect and identify with it, especially seeing all the obstacles I went through, whether it was my father dying 2 days after I gave birth, or my mother dying, or my little brother dropping dead on the day my father died 7 years later, or even as recent as my daughter being diagnosed with a brain tumor and us living in a hospital for 2.5 months, and she's now legally blind. I documented all of that. So it's gonna be, but it has a triumphant, a beautiful triumphant ending, but it has some really heartbreaking moments. But through it all, you just see me pushing through and staying with my intentions to bring good vibrations to people, to bring joy, to bring hope to others, to inspire others. And that's the driving thought throughout the whole documentary. Like, I just never gave up. And that's what I hope everyone walks away from. Like, oh man, I can still do it. She's 50.
Such an inspiration, Janice. We can't wait to check that out. We're going to go into your song, There Must Be Love. I listened to this earlier when I was getting ready and I was like, let's turn this up. It's an absolute tune, isn't it?
Thank you. Well, I always say love greets us in our most joyous times in life, whether it's a wedding or a birthday or the birth of a new baby, we're surrounded by our loved ones, right? But also in our darkest hour, when we lose our loved ones or when trauma happens, people that love us come to us. So I say there must be love because whether it's the highs or the lows, there must be love because that is the most quintessential factor in our lives is love. So I wanted to share that.
Okay, check this out. I'll be speaking with Janice.
Love, it is there, it is yours, it is power. Love, when it hurts, when it heals, when it showers. Love, when you can, when you doubt, in that hour. Love will never leave you. Love, when you fear, when you're lost, and you're broken. Love, when you cry, when you weep, feel alone, just love.
Wake up call, you must listen now.
choice of yours. Ain't No Mountain High Enough. Woohoo! What a tune.
Ain't No Mountain High Enough. Yeah.
I was going to say, why have you chosen this song? But I think it is the theme of today, isn't it? Go for it.
The reason why I chose this song, first of all, is because it is absolutely inspirational from the moment, from the first words you hear. You know, there is nothing that would ever keep me from my fans. And what I went through to come back, you know, 20 something years later, to still be standing here with a smile on my face, you know what? There is no mountain high enough that could ever keep me from bringing joy and hope and love and inspiration to others. So namaste, everybody. Be a dreamer and remember, ain't no mountain high enough, honey.
We're going to play that out on the show now. But we want to remind everyone at home to check out the remix of Dreamer. We'll put details on the screen below of how you can do that. Also, do keep us posted on when your documentary comes out, because we definitely want to watch that. It's one to watch. But Janice, I could talk to you all day. I know we could literally have a cup of tea and put the world to rights.
Yes.
And this conversation could go on forever. I feel totally inspired. Your energy is just wonderful, and thank you for giving up the time to come and join us on our Saturday night show.
Thank you so much for having me. To everybody out there, just keep dreaming, just keep hoping, just keep believing, and wake up and put a smile on your face, because that smile brings joy to others.
Oh, wise words there. Well, it is the one and only Janice Robinson, everyone. For being such a great guest on tonight's show, and thank you to you at home for supporting the show. It's really appreciated. Thank you. I'll see you same time, same place next week, and I'm going to leave you with Saturday Night Song of the Week.
Hey Hayley, thank you for playing Country Girl. I am so excited to share it with you guys. It's been a long time coming since I released something, so I'm really excited to show you guys Country Girl. Country Girl was recorded at London Road Studios. So thank you to you guys, and thanks to Max for doing an awesome job. It sounds amazing, better than I could ever have wished for.
I sold my soul to the devil. Became who I didn't want to be. Sometimes it's good to be an individual. Should have just stayed me. You were searching for just to see the pretty